You how to put a clutch in your Mitsubishi Evolution. This will be the same for the 8 and 9, maybe some other models. I'm only sure that it's the same for the 8 and the 9. First step, get the car up in the air. Jack stands, lift, however, just get it slightly up off the ground. And it's not even technically the first step you need to do. It's just I like to be able to bend, not have to be bent way over, hurt my back working on the car. The first thing you want to do is start removing everything that's above the transmission. In this case, I removed a couple items, but I'll show you what they are. We got the mass airflow meters removed, the batteries removed, the piping from the throttle body to the turbos removed. And these items are laying here. I also had a catch can that was in the way. The next item to be removed now will be this battery tray. And then there's going to be a few more things on top, such as the shifter cables. And I'll show you those in the next steps and all that. And then we'll pick up the video there. But basically, the first step is to get it at a comfortable level and start removing everything that's blocking your view of the top of the transmission. And next thing, like I said, is the battery tray. So we'll get that out of the way, and we'll pick up the video after the next step's ready. So pretty much everything that's connected to the top of the transmission, you have to remove and get it out of your way. Just kind of tuck things back. I used a piece of mechanics wire here and wired the shifter cable thing back up against the firewall so it's clear back in here a little bit. There's a switch there, which I'm not an Evo person yet. I just got this thing, but I'm thinking that's probably for the reverse lights, maybe? That's what it looks like. So probably a reverse light sensor. You don't have to pull it out of the block back or the transmission back there because it's kind of a pain in the ass to get your hands in there. You can just unhook these, let it lay. Any wire loom that's fastened anywhere to the transmission, obviously undo and get out of your way. There's one in here. Got to get this ground off and this bolt out here. So the clutch slave cylinder can just lay right up on top of your valve cover there, out of your way. And pretty much, I mean, it looks like if I would take this rad hose out of the way, it would free up some space a little bit, but then I got to mess with the draining of the coolant. And I think I'm going to try doing it without taking that off. That's not that hard the way it looks. So yeah, pretty much clear everything you can out of up here. Get it all kind of tied back and out of the way. Nothing touching the transmission. Open up as much space as you can. And then we'll pick up with the next step after that. I want to point out one thing I was wrong. This is the reverse light here. I got to looking at a little closer. That back there is the vehicle speed sensor. But either way, I believe you can leave them both in. And I mean, technically, I shouldn't have even really unhooked this one, because they're not going to hurt anything or get in the way of anything. So, okay, so under the car, and our steps under here are going to be to drain the transmission fluid with this bolt here. And while that's draining, we're going to go ahead and get the starter out. Now, looking at the starter here, I think that I'm going to have to take the exhaust down. So, you undo your exhaust here, and back here, and then you get this pipe here out of the way. So I believe that's going to have to happen to get the starter out of there. I'm going to try to get the starter out without doing that, but I'm pretty sure I'll have to. And then also we'll take this tin shield off. Looks like a couple little bolts in there. So drain the fluid. I like to use kitty litter pans. They are very big and usually do a good job catching it, and they hold a lot. So that's going to be the step I'm going to do now, and then I will pick up the video when that's finished. So you definitely have to take the exhaust down, not just to get the starter out, but to move the transfer case when it comes time. So first step then is going to be to undo the power wire at the starter and this clip here for the solenoid. And then we'll remove this tin cover, and then I think we're going to remove the axles. So we will pick up after we get the axles removed. Pretty much everybody should know how to remove axles, but in case you don't, it's pretty much just going to be tire off, ball joint loose, nut off the end of the axle, pull out on the, pop the ball joint down, pull out on the spindle, and then you're going to pry out here to knock this axle loose, and then on this side do the same thing, and then pry out in here, to knock this axle loose. So we'll pick up with the video after the axles are off and out, starter out, and this tin shield out, and we'll pick up from there. Picking up here, the axles are both out. Basically, just like I told you how to do, I used a pry bar, pried this down when I undid the ball joint, undid the nut here, pry them out of the transmission, etc. So to recap, we pretty much removed everything that was in our way up here. Actually, now that I have the starter unhooked, I can even get this wire harness here up and tucked back further out of the way. Kind of opened up a lot more freeness there. So everything was removed up top and disconnected that might be hooked to the transmission. Then we undid the exhaust, and you can see everything laying there, the axles, the exhaust, the starter, the tin shield for the starter. We've drained the transfer case and the transmission both. And now that brings us up to a tricky part in this here. That shaft that you see sticking out of the transmission there has to come out. It's got a threaded end in it. Let's see. Let me get in there. That hole that you see in the end of it is threaded. And we can try to thread a bolt into there and maybe a pry bar with a washer on the end of the bolt to try to pop that out. Or I have an idea. I got a puller here with a hook on the end of it. A slide hammer style things. So I'm going to find a bolt in my junk drawer here that fits that thread. I think I read somewhere it was a 125 pitch, but I don't remember. M10, I think. So something like that will probably end up fitting in there. Then we need to try to remove. Let's see. Yeah, that fits perfect. So what I'll do is I'll put a washer on there or something. Actually, that bolt has a pretty good lip on it. And thread that sucker in pretty decent. And I think I'm going to remove this too. This is kind of getting in my way. That's just a couple of these shitty clips. In fact, that one's not even doing anything already. So I'll get that out of the way. And then I'm going to slide hammer that shaft out. And once that shaft's out, I'll pick up with the video with the next steps. Hey guys, the shaft is out. Here you can see it. A little bolt sticking out of the bottom there. That's what I threaded into it. I just used the lip of the bolt with the edge of my dent puller. A couple sharp cracks, and she slid right out. So now we got to get this cross member out of the way. Right here. So I'm going to go ahead and loosen these 17 millimeter bolts, two in the front, one in the back. And then I'm going to take out the bolt through this motor mount. And then once the motor mount bolt's taken out, I'm going to take the cross member off completely. So we'll pick up the video with that cross member and that motor mount unhooked. So the cross member's removed, front motor mount's undone. Now we got to get the transfer case out of the way. Transfer case has six bolts holding it. Looks like they're going to be a pain in the butt to get to, because I'll show you where the easy ones are. Hey, here's three of them, and then there's going to be three more on the top. I mean, I can reach them, I just can't really show you unless I put the camera up in here. Let's look and see. There they are. One, two, three. So we undo those six bolts. One, two, three. And the ones on the top. And then what we're going to do is we're going to slide the transfer case this way and get it over here as far as we can away from the transmission. I'm not going to take it out of the car completely, I don't think, because I don't think it'll come out without dropping this cross member right here. And I don't feel that we need to have it out. So I'm going to try and just bring it over here as far as I can, and then maybe use a bungee cord or some mechanics wire or something just to wire it over and get it out of the way. So we'll pick the video up with me having the transfer case undone and slid over, and we'll go to the next step. All right, guys, as you see here, the transfer case is slid back. Kind of have it tucked back in here, away from the transmission. I want to point out that there's an O-ring right here. And as you see, one of the O-rings kind of, there's another O-ring that's kind of stuck to the tranny up there. That needs to go over into the transfer case, into that one port right there that's recessed for it. So it kind of stuck to the tranny instead. Don't lose either one of them or damage either one of them. And watch for dripping fluid. It wants to keep dripping here no matter how much I wipe it out. And I drained it, so I'm not sure. I'll just probably end up stuffing a paper towel in there for now, just so it lets me alone. So, anyway, that's the transfer case moved over. I don't know if I can get it tucked back in any more than that. I'm going to work on doing that right now. And then we'll pick the video up with the next step. Of course, I'm going to rescue that O-ring up there, too, and get it put into its spot. And then we'll pick up from there. So now we have the transfer case pulled back and out of the way. It's time to start taking some of these bell housing bolts out. I'm going to start with the two underneath here. Oh, I'll show you. I'm going to take this one out next. And its twin over here. Take them out. And there's some nasty stuff on that there. Once I have those two out, then I'm going. Then I pretty much should be done with underneath here. I don't see anything else that's got the car fastened to the transmission in any way. So yeah, these two bolts here, and then I think we'll come up here and we'll put a jack underneath the transmission to hold it in place. And we'll go ahead and remove this mount. So I'll pick up with those bolts removed and this mount undone and a jack under the transmission. And then we'll pick up from there with the next step. All right, so we're about ready to take out the last bolts to get the transmission out. I have the engine supported by a jack and the transmission. That back mount that was here is gone. There was two 17 millimeters. You have to use a wrench down through the top. This mount's out. So really the only thing left is a couple bell housing bolts and the throwout bearing fastened yet to the pressure plate. So to release the throwout bearing, which we've already done, so we'll show you how to do it. Do you want to push that back to the other way? Okay, so now you see the throwout bearing's hooked on. Have a friend hold the clutch lever back. Go ahead and pull it back. While they're holding it back, you take a screwdriver and you go between.
Can you get between there?
Yep. I'm trying to show it happened though. It's a bit with the camera. All right, so anyway, right between.
Will it loosen it up yet?
Not yet. Right between that that silver thing and the throwout bearing, you put the screwdriver. Let me get it in there a while. And then you twist the screwdriver, let go.
It'll work. Get it in there?
I didn't get it in there.
It was easier when I had it loose. Get it in there. You see that space?
Kinda. Go ahead. All right, let go. All right, there's the space. Yep, I see it. All right, so now the screwdriver's in that space.
Now let me pull it.
Pull it. And then twist. Is it hard to twist? Yep. Okay, so twist it real hard. Now you see it's left go. You need to do that before you take the transmission out. So you pop that throwout bearing loose. It takes a friend to help with the arm up there. And now we're going to take out the last of the bell housing bolts. Should be only a couple left. Looks like there's one here. And one there. So two left. And then we'll be sliding this tranny out and setting it on the ground. And we'll pick up from there. The transmission is out, and it is not easy to clear that right there. So we just kept wrestling with it and fighting with it and maneuvering it, and it finally just fell out. So it's out. I don't know how it's going back in just yet. We'll figure that out. But anyway, the next step now is obviously, since we're doing a clutch, is to remove this clutch. So we're gonna do that next. And get around to installing a new one, and then we'll try to get this put back in. Clutch taken out. You see somebody's replaced it in the past. It says Xeti on it. You can see that it's definitely smoked. It was holding pretty much until you built full boost, and then it would just slip a little bit and then chutter and bite again. But we measured the pads, and they're pretty thin. They're only, what, 25 thousandths? Or 25, 0.25. And the new clutch was 0.31, so anyway, there's not much of a lip on my flywheel. What you want to check is your flywheel. See how bad there's a lip here. This barely has any lip. Pretty insignificant, so we're just going to take the cookie cutter and kind of go over the surface and freshen it up. And we're going to put the new clutch on and then try to figure out how to get this transmission back in. So the clutch is installed. And all torque to spec. Next thing we're going to do is do the throwout bearing. First step to do the throwout bearing is to punch out this little brass plug at the top with a socket. Let's find one that fits. Get the next size down so it passes through with it.
That should be that one, right there. Should go right through.
Okay. We're going to punch the brass plug out. Okay, there we go. Yeah.
That's so bad behind there. Might need a magnet to get that up.
It's brass, it won't be magnetic. But anyway, so save that because that goes back in. And now that we have that plug out, we can go down through here and we're going to take out this bolt right here, and then we're going to be able to slide this shaft up out that hole to be able to take the fork off to replace the throwout bearing. And then we'll pick up from there.
Throwout bearing's replaced.
It's kind of a pain in the ass like everything else with this. You punch out this brass plug, and then you take out this 10 millimeter, and then you're able to drive up. It's kind of a pain in the butt. You drive this shaft up and out the hole, and then these springs, and there's a felt between the spring and the fork on each side, a little felt washer. Those will come out. And then you can take the throwout bearing off the fork and put the new one on. And then just reverse the procedure to put it back together. The trick is getting the felt washers back in between without destroying them too much. And then torque the bolt back down there and you're done. Some people say to put a little bit of a grease or something on there. I am the type that tends to not want to put a grease on there, but you may want to. It's up to you, unless you have a real good high temp grease. Now we're just going to have to try to figure out how to get this sucker back in the car now. That's the reverse procedure, and we'll pick up with the video once
transmission
we figure that out.
Transmission back in, and bell housing bolts, rear mount. I went ahead and hooked up the slave cylinder quick, even though I probably shouldn't have just yet, but, just so I could test the clutch and see, make sure it worked.
Hold on a sec.
So, yeah, definitely a lot of work to do one of these. I've done a lot of Hondas, and these are by far harder than the Honda. I mean, this is ridiculous. So, if you have to change a clutch in your Evo on your own, I wouldn't try to scare you away from doing it. I mean, it's straightforward and just time-consuming.
You basically, you know, have to have some sort of mechanical skill. Sorry, I'm just cleaning up some antifreeze there. I took my radiator out so I could pull the motor forward more to try to clear the bell housing. So yeah, it's definitely a humbling experience. I wouldn't call it expert level. I mean, there are harder things to do than this, but I'm not finished yet, obviously. I still have a lot to go yet. I gotta try to get that transfer case back on without boogering up those O-rings. I mean, there's some work ahead of me yet, a few hours. But I wanted to get you caught up to where we're at. So transmission's back in, and now we just reverse all the steps we did initially. So we're going to do the mounts, upper and lower mounts. Things like the lower mount with the cross member. Just basically reverse all the steps in the video. I'll still pick the video up here and give you a couple updates as I go, let you know how things are going. But pretty much this is an all-day affair. You know, you look it up on a garage's labor, and the garage is going to tell you 9 hours minimum, they claim. And that's with a lift and all their professional tools and their know-how. So don't be surprised if this job takes you, you know, better part of a day and a half. I've been out here for, I've been out here at least 6-7 hours now, and I'm still not done. I've been doing videos, and I took a break to go eat and whatnot, but it's still a long all-day thing, you know, nothing like the Hondas. Man, I can have a transmission in and out of that, and that's all-wheel drive, as most of you know who watch my videos. You Mitsubishi guys probably don't know me.
But that Civic is converted to all-wheel drive, and I can have that transmission out in an by myself 45 minutes with ease, and tear it apart if I'm rebuilding it, synchronizers or whatever, and back in the car in like 3-4 hours tops, you know, rebuilding the transmission completely. So this is definitely a new experience for me. But anyway, I'm gonna get back to work here, and then we'll pick up the video
guys, just a small update.
I've got the bottom cross member on. I'll show you underneath there. Not too much more up top since we spoke last. Recap though, we got the rear mount way back in there. Back mount, top mount. Still got a bunch to do up there. We'll get caught up on that. Pretty much underneath it was real simple stuff. We got tin shield back in. I did that first. After the tin shield, I stuck the starter in. And after the starter, I put the transfer case in and those 6 bolts I showed you earlier. And I stuck this cross member back in and that mount. Now I'm going to do the, I'm going to go up and feed the wires down for the starter so I can do them. That way when I stick the exhaust on, they're not blocked. And then I'm going to come down and stick the exhaust back on. And the little cross beam that went across right there. Where is it? Right there behind the slide hammer. Little black cross beam. So and then that'll be done underneath. The underneath will be wrapped back up. And then we will end up sliding that shaft over there back into the transmission. And we will go ahead and stick the axles back in the ball joints. And then the rest will just be wrapping up top and to fill fluids. And of course now I gotta put my radiator back in because I took that out. So I'll probably pick up the video here shortly with some of that stuff done. It's pretty straightforward, just a bunch of time consuming. And we'll go from there. Okay. Got the top of the setup put back all together, radiator back in, mass airflow, piping, hoses, all that's done. Still have to do the axles yet, and that shaft that goes in through the transmission into the transfer case. And then a plastic shield, and then I could actually put the tires on and test it. So we'll pick back up then with how to adjust the clutch pedal and all that. Still putting some water in. Now's the chance where I'm going to fire it up and actually see how it sounds. See where the pedal engages at, and I'd like to show you guys, but it's really hard to see, but up underneath the dash where the clutch pedal goes through the flywheel, there's a rod with a nut on the end of it, and you're not going to be able to see, I have no light right now, but that nut, you can loosen it and you can adjust the length of that rod, and you want to end up getting your clutch pedal to engage about an inch or two off the floor, about halfway through the pedal's travel, basically. Figure out how many inches the pedal's travel is, and you should try to adjust your clutch so that somewhere in the middle of the travel, it engages. Not all the way up real high, and definitely not right off the floor. So I'm going to fire the car up now. Obviously, I got to put the camera down, and so you're not going to be able to witness that. But I'm going to fire it up now and just listen for any weird sounds.
Okay.
Let it run. So I'm going to fire it up, let it circulate. Let it get up to temperature, make sure there's no air bubbles in the cooling system, make sure that the transmission and everything sounds okay, and the clutch engages properly, the gears go through. I'm not even going to put the front tires on at this point because I have another project lined up here tomorrow. I'm going to be sticking this coilover kit set on the car. So anyway, that's what I'm going to do now, and I'll wrap up the video, this tutorial after that.